Television shows may seem like a lot of fun to film when you're watching them from the couch, but in certain cases, they can be an absolute torture, just like your own workplace. Sometimes there are relationships on the TV set that are slightly less than perfect. Grey's Anatomy's Katherine Heigl created tension to the extreme when she publicly removed herself from Emmy consideration the year after she won the award, blaming the writers for not giving her enough good material. Rumors that she was a diva on set and difficult to work with continued up until she left the show, about a year and a half later. Speaking to The Hollywood Reporter in 2014, Grey's creator Shonda Rhimes seemed to imply that it was Heigl who catalyzed Rhimes' quote, "no a**s" policy on the set of her follow-up hit Scandal. Rhimes didn't bother mincing words in the interview. "There are no Heigls in this situation. I don't put up with bullshit or nasty people. I don't have time for it." Years later, in an interview with Howard Stern, Heigl spoke about the controversy, saying, "I went to see Shonda and said, 'I'm so sorry, that wasn't cool. And I should not have said that. And I shouldn't have said anything publicly. But at the time, I didn't think anyone would notice. I just quietly didn't submit, and then it became a story. And I felt I was obligated to make my statement. And I should have just said, 'Shut up, Katie.' Yeah, probably." In 2014, TMZ reported that Glee co-stars Naya Rivera and Lea Michele got into a legitimate tiff while filming an episode of their hit musical comedy series. To this day, nobody really knows what the fight was actually about. During a 2017 interview on E! News, series creator Ryan Murphy finally addressed the feud, saying, "I feel like in the case of that show was just a shitstorm of difficulty."
What do you do when you're 18 years old or 19 years old and you wake up the next day and you're world famous? I think a lot of that was informed by their youth and being involved in a phenomenon.
Fans of CBS show Criminal Minds were shocked in August 2016 when news broke that the series star Thomas Gibson would not be returning as Agent Aaron Hotchner. It turns out that Gibson had initially been suspended for 2 episodes after kicking writer and producer Virgil Williams during an argument. Eventually, however, he was written out of the show, on which he'd appeared for 11 seasons. According to The Hollywood Reporter, the incident occurred during an episode that Gibson was actually directing. THR further explains that this wasn't the first time Gibson had lashed out at a coworker. He allegedly pushed an assistant director for the show a few years earlier and ended up in mandated anger management classes. It also seems that Gibson had a contentious relationship with his co-star Shamar Moore. In August 2016, Vulture reported on a seemingly shady Instagram video that Moore posted right after Gibson was fired, and then deleted, saying, "I'll just say this, I believe in karma." A battle over creative control erupted during the first season of Roseanne, one that the eponymous star ultimately won. Speaking to Entertainment Weekly, Roseanne Barr revealed how she forced ABC to part with writer and creator Matt Williams, saying, "I said, 'I want to break the contract, I quit. They told me Matt would be out by show 13. 13 has always been my lucky number, so I ate shit until then." After cleaning out his desk, Williams spoke to the Los Angeles Times, claiming that his dismissal was, quote, "symptomatic of an industry disdain for writers in general." Those words would ring true in the years that followed, as Barr continued to feud with her writers. Barr got pretty candid when Entertainment Weekly had a, quote, "Roseanne family reunion" in 2008. And she didn't hold back when she described her writer team as egocentric. The actor revealed that she wouldn't even refer to them by name, using numbers she'd allocated instead. Amy Sherman-Palladino, who would later create Gilmore Girls, said, "The writers did not think it was funny. Anytime you tell someone, 'I'm not going to learn your name, here's your number,' you're diminishing their worth." When Roseanne was renewed for a belated 10th season in 2017, Barr claimed that all the drama was ancient history. She told Entertainment Weekly, quote, "I don't want to fight no more." Yet she just couldn't stay out of trouble. Barr was sacked the following year after a racist tweet.
"I knew it!
No, no, wait, Roseanne, this is a mistake."
"You bet it is!"
In 2005, at the peak of the success of ABC's primetime soap, Desperate Housewives, the principal cast members reportedly got into it at a shoot for the cover of Vanity Fair. According to People, ABC told Vanity Fair that Terry Hatcher couldn't get first dibs on wardrobe or take over the shoot, suggesting that the rest of the cast wasn't happy with her behavior on set. Hatcher ultimately arrived at the set early, setting off a chain of events that allegedly ended with Marsha Cross storming off the shoot and Hatcher crying on the phone. The feud between Hatcher and the rest of the Desperate Housewives cast reportedly continued throughout the show's 7-season run. In 2010, Desperate Housewives star Nicolette Sheridan sued ABC for wrongful termination and battery after claiming she was hit on the head by the show's creator Mark Cherry, and subsequently written off the show for complaining about the incident. The suit went to trial in 2012, during which Cherry testified that he tapped Sheridan on the head and that the tap was only done to help demonstrate how Sheridan's scene should play out. A judge ultimately declared a mistrial after the jury became deadlocked. Subsequent lawsuits were tossed out as well. As an aside, Cherry's testimony also seemed to confirm Hatcher's feud with the rest of the cast. past. At one point, he recalled an incident in which Hatcher and Sheridan were fighting on set. As reported by E! News, Nicolette pulled me aside and told me that Terry Hatcher was the meanest woman in the world because of how she was acting. Incidentally, Cherry also testified that co-stars Eva Longoria and Felicity Huffman were, quote, relieved when Sheridan was written off the show. The irony of the show's title couldn't have been lost on those who worked on NBC's beloved but highly troubled show, Community. The Community college comedy made unwanted headlines in 2012 when star Chevy Chase was accused of using the N-word on set, according to Deadline. Chase reportedly used the slur in protest after being shown some dialogue he didn't agree with, suggesting that his hopelessly bigoted character Pierce would be asked to use it in reference to his black co-stars the way things were going. The cast didn't appreciate his reasoning, however, and he promptly apologized. Joel McHale would later tell Howard Stern that Chase claimed Richard Pryor permitted him to use the N-word. Showrunner Dan Harmon clashed with Chase on numerous occasions. Speaking to The New Yorker in 2018, Harmon recalled a time he had to apologize to Donald Glover after, quote, a particularly rough night of Chevy's non-PC verbiage. What did Chase say exactly? According to Harmon, Chase told Glover that, "People think you're funnier because you're black." Harmon believes that Chase was threatened by the clearly talented Glover, who refused to take the bait. The actor and musician told the publication, "I just saw Chevy as fighting time. A true artist has to be okay with his reign being over. I can't help him if he's thrashing in the water, but I know there's a human in there somewhere. He's almost too human."
I'm done with whatever you call this. Adios.
When Shannen Doherty left Charmed amidst mysterious circumstances in 2001, she left a trail of rumors about a beef with co-star Alyssa Milano. Doherty, who portrayed Prue, told Entertainment Tonight that she decided to split because she was totally over on-set feuds. "There was too much drama on the set and not enough passion for the work. I'm 30 years old, and I don't have time for drama in my life anymore." But did she really walk away, or was she asked to leave? In 2013, Milano restoked the fire somewhat when she appeared on Watch What Happens Live with Andy Cohen and said, "I don't know if Shannen got fired. We never really found out what happened. There were definitely some rough days." When Milano spoke to E! News 4 years later, she revealed that she and Doherty privately reconnected via Twitter. After Doherty was diagnosed with breast cancer, she said, "I think that what she has gone through and motherhood in my life, I think it just changes people. I'm so happy that she's feeling well. I prayed for her every day that she would feel well, and I can't wait to see her." Doherty was in remission at the time, though sadly, she would receive a second breast cancer diagnosis in 2019. In a February 2020 Instagram update, the actor said that she was focusing on looking after herself and, quote, embracing every day. Sex and the City co-stars Sarah Jessica Parker and Kim Cattrall reportedly fell out in 2004, when Cattrall discovered she was being paid much less than SJP for the hit show's final season. Parker later played down their beef in an interview with Elle, claiming it was fabricated. She said, "I don't think anybody wants to believe that I love Kim. I adore her." She did, however, acknowledge that there was some friction when she spoke to Marie Claire in 2010, blaming the show's long hours, saying, "There are times when all of us have been sensitive and sometimes feelings get hurt." Parker seemed ready to move on, but Cattrall had other plans. When Piers Morgan interviewed Cattrall in 2017, she said that she's never been friends with her Sex and the City co-stars, and that Parker in particular could have been nicer to her. SJP's attempts at friendliness blew up in her face when Cattrall's brother tragically died the following year. When Parker sent her condolences, Cattrall lashed out in a fiery Instagram post, saying, "Let me make this very clear, if I haven't already. You are not my family. You are not my friend." Cattrall went on to accuse Parker of exploiting her tragedy to further Parker's, quote, nice girl persona. Yikes. According to E! Online, actress Janet Hubert was fired from her role as Aunt Vivian after the third season of The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air due to creative differences. Actress Daphne Maxwell Reed was quickly brought in as a replacement. What led to the shocking cast swap? Star Will Smith shed a little light on the backstage drama in a 1993 radio interview, saying, "I can say straight up that Janet Hubert wanted the show to be the Aunt Viv of Bel-Air show. No matter what, to her, I'm just the Antichrist." Smith's co-star Alfonso Ribeiro also riffed on the feud during a comedy set, saying bluntly, "There were days when we were all in the set and she would just literally go off on people. We felt like, when we were doing The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, that we were a family. She, at that point, ruined that, and she made it very difficult for us to work." And unfortunately, she was then fired. For her part, Hubert denied any wrongdoing in a 2016 interview on The Real, momentarily speaking of herself in the third person.
"Janet Hubert was never difficult on that set. Janet Hubert was so professional, it wasn't even funny."
She went on to say, "I think Will simply needed to win, and I think sometimes when you get caught up in a lie and those things never happened, she never left the set. I never left the set. We got along great." Two and a Half Men star Charlie Sheen appeared to burn bridges with creator Chuck Lorre in 2011. going on a bizarre series of rants that led to his firing from the popular sitcom. Lori apparently joked that he would be mad if the hard-partying Sheen outlived him. Sheen took this personally and proceeded to trash Lori to numerous outlets. He called Lori a clown on The Alex Jones Show and would later brand him, quote, a stupid, stupid little man and a punk when TMZ asked for his thoughts. It probably won't surprise you to learn that Sheen didn't let it go. 6 years after he was sacked, he once again went off on Lori, calling him a, quote, ridiculous imposter during an interview with Kiss 106.5's Kyle and Jackie O, exclaiming, Chuck Lori, I hope you're listening. Hey Chuck, suck my f***ing butt. But in 2018, Sheen expressed some uncharacteristic remorse when he spoke to Australia's Today Show. Asked if he'd made up with Lori yet, Sheen said, I haven't in person. It is a thing I really want to mend. Even though The X-Files came back for another season in 2016, and co-stars David Duchovny and Gillian Anderson seemed like best of pals now, it wasn't always smooth sailing on the set of Fox's sci-fi smash hit. In a February 2015 interview with The Guardian, Anderson admitted that, "...there were definitely periods when we hated each other. Hate is too strong a word. We didn't talk for long periods of time. It was intense, and we were both pains in the arse for the other at various times." For his part, Duchovny told Variety that, quote, "...the crucible of doing that show made monsters out of both of us. It seems that, in this instance, time heals all wounds, however, and Duchovny and Anderson are now able to work peacefully side by side." Duchovny further explained to Variety, "...once we got to step back, it was like, oh, wow, we really like each other. The way we work together has changed. All's well that ends well, and now that everyone's best friends again, we just want to know, when's the next season coming?" Emotions regularly run high on Empire, and reports suggest that the turmoil can sometimes continue after the cameras have stopped rolling. In 2017, tabloids claimed that execs had been dealing with behind-the-scenes fighting between Taraji P. Henson and Season 3 guest star Nia Long, who were apparently refusing to film scenes together. According to insiders, Long's difficult behavior with the hair, wardrobe, and makeup teams prompted an angry reaction from the series' regular. TMZ reported, "...they stopped speaking to each other when they were on set. Our sources say it was next to impossible to film the scenes they did together, and that's why they had actually blocked out how to shoot those scenes separately." A second source told E! News that things escalated when newcomer Long overstepped her mark, saying, "...tensions calmed between them towards the end of the season, but it comes down to the fact that they both have been in the industry for so long, and both want to be the star. Unfortunately for Nia, Taraji is the star of Empire. And no one and nothing will ever change that." Henson has remained tight-lipped in the years since, but Long seemed to stir the pot when she spoke to TV Once Uncensored in 2018, saying, "...Nia Long knows her light, Nia Long knows her makeup, Nia Long knows her hair, and you probably can't talk me into something else. If you want to call that difficult, then sorry." Much has been written about Lena Headey and Jerome Flynn's rumored romance, but what exactly went down between these two Game of Thrones stars? Headey Cersei Lannister and Flynn Ser Bronn of the Blackwater shared the screen briefly during Season 3, but they curiously never appeared in a single scene together after that. The two are thought to have met back in 1993 when Headey appeared on Soldier Soldier, a British drama series headlined by Flynn and his one-time musical partner Robson Green. Flynn denied that anything was going on when The Sun questioned him about Headey in 2003, though interestingly, he refused to, quote, rule out a relationship with her. Whether they dated at the time remains unclear, but if they did, it didn't last. Headey married from 2007 to 2012, then married again in 2018. It's the period in between that she supposedly got involved or re-involved with Flynn, though The Guardian once mentioned rumors of some overlap. Whatever happened, it apparently ended badly. An insider told The Sun ahead of the Game of Thrones finale in 2019, "...Lena and Jerome have not filmed together due to a bad breakup. They kept the full extent of it secret, but it was a very turbulent relationship, and it has been very awkward on set. She appears to have a genuine hate towards him." Star Trek legends George Takei and William Shatner remain locked in a feud that has spanned several decades. They worked on the original series together from 1966 to 1969, and would co-star later in six Star Trek feature films, giving them plenty of time to get under each other's skin. Their beef became common knowledge when Takei opened up about it in his 1994 autobiography, To the Stars, claiming that Shatner would pretend not to know him on set, and even had a movie script altered so that Takei Sulu wouldn't get his own starship. It's been a tit-for-tat war of words ever since. The feud flared up big time in 2008, when Shatner claimed to have not been invited to Takei's wedding. Shatner was quoted by the New York Post as saying, "...there's such a sickness there. It's so painfully obvious that there's a psychosis there. I don't know what his original thing about me was. I have no idea. I didn't read his book that was printed many years ago." Takei told the Edmonton Journal that Shatner's invitation must have been lost in the mail. And in 2019, when The Guardian asked Takei what his dream dinner party would look like, he appeared to take a shot at his old foe with his answer, saying, "...my colleagues from Star Trek, with one exception." Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more Nicki Swift videos about your favorite stars and shows are coming soon! Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one!